Hello folks, this is Aditya Najha from InspireToRise.com and today we have the LaEco LaMax 2 here with us for an initial hands-on of the same. So guys, without wasting much time, let's begin. The LaMax 2 comes with a 5.7-inch display with a quad HD resolution of 2560x1440 pixels, and overall it's a good smartphone. Comes with CDLA, which is continual digital lossless audio technology, and it has a USB type C port which can be used for data transfer and charging, and also for CDLA earphones. That's good enough. And apart from that, this smartphone is quite big when you compare it to the LE2, and it has that USB type C at the bottom. You get one speaker grill at the bottom which looks like that, and you have antenna bands here and there. And on the right hand side we have the power button and the volume rocker for this smartphone, and on the left hand side you have the dual SIM tray slot which features the nano SIM. On the back you have the fingerprint sensor which is quite accurate enough, and you get the 21 megapixel camera on the back and an 8 megapixel front facing camera also. It comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 820 chipset with two options, 4 GB RAM or 6 GB RAM, and 32 GB storage or 64 GB storage. It comes with a 3100 mAh battery with quick charge 2.0, and it has connectivity options like Wi-Fi, HSPA+, 4G LTE. Overall, it's an okay smartphone, and it comes with Android 6.0.1 Marshmallow based EUI 5.6. So that's good enough, and overall feels like a decent smartphone, at least on paper. And it features the top of the line Snapdragon 820 variant, the MSM8996, so that's also something good. And overall it is not heating up that much right now. When we took it for a run and when we tried to run the Antutu benchmark and other benchmarks on it, but later when we test it in full detail we will get to know whether the smartphone really heats up or not. And that's one of the big things that you have to look out for when buying a smartphone like this, which is all metal, whether it really heats up or not. And the 6GB variant has a lot of RAM free at almost any given point of time. That is a plus. The benchmark score that we got was really bad and not an indicator of the performance. I guess it was an issue with the specific unit that we were dealing with, but the benchmark scores in terms of the other benchmarks were quite fair, quite passable enough. And the Antutu benchmark score as claimed by LaEco, guys, that comes out at around 140,000 plus, but the Geekbench 3 scores tell us a quite different story, and they do tell us about almost the real world performance of this one. So it's quite good. 2007 on the single core score is quite good benchmark performance. The primary camera is a 21 megapixel camera, has OIS for blurry photos, and you also get PDF technology so that it can focus really fast. And it comes with dual LED dual tone flash. It also has an 8 megapixel front shooter for nice selfies. And apart from that, the LE Max 2 is okay enough. The interface has a lot of features. It can also shoot 2160p 4K HD videos, and the audio that it comes with is Dolby Atmos. Even in low light conditions we got quite good selfies with the 8 megapixel camera, so that's quite commendable. And the primary camera was also able to take quite good pictures even in low light conditions. So okay enough. We have already uploaded all of the samples from the LaMax 2 in our video, so a random ANJ pops in from somewhere, that's okay. And the UI experience on this one is decent enough. You might not find too many customizations, but the things like Love You, Love ED app and other applications like the Yup TV etc. do make the overall experience quite different from other smartphones out there. Though Android has almost reached a saturation point in terms of features, as there aren't many more things that you can cram into a phone apart from the stock Android features. And as can be seen over here, the Live TV application worked quite good, provided by Yup TV, so that's something good. We also tried to watch NDTV India on this one, and it was playing fine enough on the Wi-Fi connection over there. Though the streaming quality wasn't the best in class, but it also depends upon your internet connection. And the display comes with Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection, which is quite good, because the Gorilla Glass 4 protection isn't always as good as the Gorilla Glass 3 protection. And Love ED etc. applications present on this one. The price for the 6GB RAM variant is around 29,990, around 30,000 rupees, and the price is around 23,000 rupees for the 4GB RAM variant. Overall, it's an okay smartphone. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to hit the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. This is Aditya Najha from InspireToRise.com signing off, folks. Stay inspired, guys.